Our brains are very powerful computers. We can process very complex tasks much more efficiently than conventional computers. So if you watch the movie Avatar, the home tree is a very good metaphor for a neuron. So if you think about it, you have one tree, one neuron, which has thousands of leaves, which are then connected to thousands of other neurons. The connections between each neuron and its neighbors is not static, it actually can be adapted. In fact, it's adapted constantly on the fly. So that's why we can learn things, we can do tasks that were not told to us. Well, computers, we have to tell them what to do and train them for specific tasks.
Basically, we're developing a new type of electronic switch, and we're primarily interested in this device because it mimics the behavior of a biological neuron. Conventional computers are built out of transistors. It's just a digital switch, but each individual device can only connect to a few other devices in its local neighborhood. Whereas in a biological system, you have these billions of neurons and, you know, millions of synapses that allow them to reach, you know, beyond their local neighborhood. So our devices exhibit some of the dynamics of a synapse in that they grow stronger connections the more they're used, and they also can connect to, you know, many other devices, not just what's locally around them. So this way we can design a new computing architecture that is not based on a separation between memory and the CPU, which is what you normally find. Instead, we're looking at a distributed computing where computations happen, you know, all over the design, and they're all happening in parallel. So this gives us a very different type of computing. To enable this kind of connection, we're using nanoscale devices.
We develop a new type of device structure. These devices are so-called two-terminal resistive switches, or some people call them memristors. A memristor is basically a resistor with memory. It's a very simple structure so that it can be used to connect a large number of processing units.
I think what you would expect to see in the end is computers that, if they're built with our devices, they'll be good at things that a human is good at. So driving or identifying objects or identifying faces. They probably won't be as good at calculating exact figures, but you will see them able to do the kind of thing where they can learn without being taught or without being explicitly programmed.